particular lesson in two parts. And in the first part, today, we're going to learn a tune. And then in the second part of the lesson, we'll take the tune, add some ornamentation and some bowing techniques, and just learn how to make the tune your own. And the tune that I've chosen is one that I've had a lot of requests for by email and on Facebook. It's a tune that I wrote called A Riverboat's Gone, and that's a waltz that I wrote in memory of the late John Hartford, one of my favorite musicians. Before you learn a tune, it's a really good idea to be able to hum it or sing it, to really know the melody well enough before you pick up your instrument so that it's that much easier to find the notes and get everything happening. This is in the key of D, which means you have an F sharp and a C sharp. So something you might want to do as well is just get your instrument and kind of review the key of D before you start to learn it. One, two, three, one, two. You've listened through the tune a couple times, got it into your head. We're going to start by learning the A part. I'm going to break it down into little phrases, and that way you'll be able to take your time, repeat the phrase until you feel like you have it, and then add on to it. So here we go. So the first phrase starts on your third finger on the A string, which is a D, and goes up the scale, and I'll play the phrase for you. Just practice that. I usually use an up bow slur right here. Up, up. And the rest are separate, starting on a down. One, two, three. And the second phrase starts on the same note, but comes down. Again. One more. Let's put those phrases together. One, two, three, one, two. We're going to start on an open D, and it's much the same, only it's going to go down to the G string this time. So we've got a Let's repeat that a couple times. Again, I'm doing an up bow slur. Okay, and then the last phrase in that section. Again. So let's put those two phrases together, starting on the open D. One, two. Okay, so from the top, those four phrases. One, two, three, one, two. Done the A part. Now we are going to repeat the first two phrases that we learned, and then it changes a little bit to resolve this A section. So let's repeat those first two phrases together. One, two, three, one, two. Okay, here's where it changes. Starts on the open D again and goes up. So it sounds like this. So it jumps up to the high D. Let's try that again. And then it does, starting on the open A. So together. And then. So that whole phrase goes like this. So I've been trying to give you a good general idea of what some of the bowings should be, where some of the slurs should happen. As I said before, in the second part of this lesson, we're actually going to learn some different bowing techniques and you'll be playing around with it. So it's important for now just to do what feels comfortable. If you're in doubt and not sure where it should go, follow me the best you can. And if you're a newer beginner fiddler, don't worry about it too much. Just try and get the notes down for now and make sure that your pickup notes are having you land down bow on the strong beats where you would be tapping your foot in a waltz. All right, let's try the B part. The B part has a fair amount of repetition and kind of walks up and down on the G string a little bit. Here's the first phrase. We're starting on the open D again and going down to the G string right away. So it starts like this. In half. The first part, and then the next part starts on the low A, comes back up, and then from the B down, and it resolves F sharp E. So the whole phrase. The second phrase is going to go down to your low G, your open G. So it starts the same. It goes. And then A, G to the open D. So let's put those two together. And it ends. So let's put all that together on the open D. Okay, let's try it from the top of the B section. One, two, three, one, two. One, two, three, one, two. second ending resolves it. It goes back up. It goes like this. So start on the open D. If you're comfortable with it, one thing you can do in the B part is add some slurs on those low B to A, A to G. I'll show you where I mean. So, slur, slur. To do them all, and you don't have to do any if you're not comfortable with it, but some of the stuff that we're going to do in the second lesson will build on that bowing. So if you're comfortable with it, go ahead and throw some of those slurs in there. All right, that's it. Great job. Take your time, go back, let the tune sink in, keep working on it, and I look forward to seeing you in the second lesson so we can work on making this tune your own. Have a good one. Thank you.